Hello everybody, Dr. Carlo Ogieri, emergency physician. In this video, we're actually going to talk about one of the coolest procedures in emergency medicine, which is chest tube placement. Essentially, it's putting a tube into the chest, as the name says. And it's one of the coolest things because one of the few times where you have to do it, it could potentially be life-threatening if you don't do it quickly enough. Number three, you have permission to stab a patient, to open their chest, to kind of put your finger through the muscle layers into the chest wall, into the chest cavity, and then put a chest tube in. And that's just really, really cool. I'll be showing you some anatomy pictures from Netter, the book. The important thing is to know the relevant anatomy of the chest tube placement. Before you start doing any kind of procedure like this, number one, make sure you get consent. Number two, make sure you mark this side of the surgery. Wrong side surgery is a big deal. There's big monetary penalties on missing the wrong side, and it's not good for the patient. You're supposed to do it on one side, you do it on the other. So make sure you print a copy of the x-ray, bring a copy of the x-ray to the bedside, and corroborate with the patient that the correct side is the right or the left. Mark it with a pen before you do anything else. Get your consent signed. Make sure the patient has some analgesia, maybe some Dilaudid, some morphine, maybe some Ativan to kind of relax them, and go ahead and start the procedure. It is a fully sterile procedure. This is the one place where you want to do a surgical scrub of your hands. You want to set up into the sterile gown, get sterile gloves, get a mask on, get a hat, the full work. You want full barrier precautions, which means put the full sterile sheet over the patient so that everything's covered, and you go ahead and start your procedure. You're going to use antiseptic solution, either iodine or anything else, alcohol swipe, whatever your hospital uses to clean the area well. Let that dry, and then go ahead and start the procedure. The important thing about the anatomy, and I'm going to show you the pictures here from the Netter, is what is called the anterior axillary line, the mid-axillary line, and the posterior axillary line. And that refers to the axilla and the side here where you're going to do it. You're going to do it at the height of the nipple. So you look at the patient's nipple, and right there, that's the side where you're going to do this. Now, sometimes doctors deviate from this because they want to drain not air, like a pneumothorax, but they want to drain blood, and they want the chest tube to be pointing down, or they want to empty an empyema, which is pus, which in the chest cavity. So they want to target it and go a little bit lower. But the danger is you got the diaphragm, which starts up here but curves like this. So if you go kind of low, you can go in through the diaphragm and into the abdominal wall, which has happened. When I was just a trainee and doing my trauma rotation, I had a fellow on trauma having put a very low chest tube for clearing an empyema, and I couldn't feel the track well. I didn't want to push it in, and he said, "No, you're in the right place. Go ahead and push it. We want it that low." I said, I still really don't feel the right space, and eventually pushed me aside, went ahead and pushed the chest tube in. And 1 month later, I find out that patient was septic, was really sick. They went to the OR to revise his abdomen and see what was going on, and they found the chest tube was actually into the patient's spleen, which is terrible. No big deal in the sense that patient got the spleen out, which was unnecessary, of course, but no major complications. Patient recovered well from that. But the point is, be careful at the site you choose. That's why it's so important to get it on the right spot. So, nipple line, anterior mid-axillary line, and that's where you're going to feel the ribs, and then that's where you're going to do your cut. So, you're all sterile, you're all gowned up, you clean the area, and you have your position, you're feeling the patient's rib, and you know to cut there. You're going to cut about that much, maybe 2 inches or so, enough that you have some space to get your finger into the chest cavity wall and feel the spaces. You want to be able to feel the ribs, so you might have to do some blunt dissections. You take your forceps, put it into the hole, and you go like that, opening up until you get to the muscle layer. Some people are very fat, so you got to go through all that fat to feel the muscle. Some people are very thin, and you'll get right on. So you dissect through until you feel your rib space. Now you want to go right above the rib. And if you look at this picture from Netter, the neurovascular bundle, the artery and the nerve, the nerve and the vein are underneath the rib. So if you go and put your chest right underneath that rib, you can nick the artery and it causes severe bleeding. You can nick the nerve and cause some peripheral neuropathy, some damage to that nerve. So you don't want to do that. You want to go right above the rib. So once you get into that space, there are different kits. So some of them have a trocar, which means a big, hard metal wire, which you used to actually stab the patient with it. remove the guide wire, and then you're already in. So you use the tube itself to push through, basically stabbing the patient. Now, the older methods were the blunt dissection. You take forceps and you dissect the muscle layer, start pushing, 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 and then you use it to pop the space, open it up with your forceps, and then keeping that space open, you keep your finger in to save that hole. You don't want to lose the spot you just made a hole. And then you take your chest tube, and then you push it through into the cavity of the chest wall. As I'm showing in this video right here, we're using the trocar method, and the doctor's trying to push that in. Now, it does require a fair amount of strength. You're actually stabbing through muscle layers into the chest cavity wall, but you have to do it right. You have to push hard and get in. And if it's for a pneumo, you should hear a pop and a whoosh, like opening a soda bottle, because the air is escaping. There should be plenty of condensation into that chest tube as you're doing this. Signifying that it's in the chest wall cavity. But the most important thing about this is make sure you're in position. The last thing you want to do is think that you're in. Go ahead and close the skin layers, tie the tube to the chest wall, go and get an x-ray, and then find out you're not even to the chest cavity. You're actually in the muscle layers and you left the tube there. It's not doing anything. Now you have to get another consent, get another moment of safety, tell the family and embarrass yourself, clean the area up, gown up again, and do it again with a new chest tube, because you don't want to introduce bacterial infection into the cavity wall, cause empyema, pneumonia, and all kinds of complications later. So you need to make sure you're in the right place. So unless you feel you're in the space, unless you can feel your finger going through the ribs, don't push that chest tube. Now, if you're using the trocar method or any kind of method where you're not really using your finger or forceps to dissect through, you're just going in, you just need to make sure you get a good flush of air, that the patient's symptomatically better, and that it feels that it threads in. Now, if it's for a chest tube placement, you don't need to put a big tube in. It can be the really small French catheters. If it's for a blood or hemothorax, then you need to put a thicker kind of tube. If it's a hemo-pneumothorax, then of course thicker tubes, and you want it to aim it up for pneumothorax. You want to aim it down for blood and things like that. So that's chest tube placement. It's a really cool procedure. I get a handful of those a year, but I always look forward to doing those. It's like Christmas, and I get to do those kinds of procedures because it's the one time I get to be a surgeon and do some cool stuff right from the ER. So I hope you enjoyed watching this video of the procedure being done. Please comment, suggestions, like the video, and I'll try to come up with some other cool videos for you guys to watch in the future. So see you soon. Bye-bye. Yeah, we need to put some